Hey everyone, for those of you who know me, you know that I'm a big Iron Man fan, and I will get my hands on anything that is Iron Man related, be it Iron Man figures, or anything to do with home automation, or gesture-based UI, or anything that remotely let me feel how it's like to become Iron Man, you bet I'll be interested. So a few years ago, I bought this Leap Motion controller by Leap Motion. So what they advertise is that with this small little device, slightly bigger than the thumb drive, it's able to give your computer gesture-based capabilities. So after watching their video, of course I'm interested, and I bought one of these. It is very lightweight, comes with a rubber base with the word Leap Motion on it, so you know you're getting a real deal. And it has a proprietary port here, and they give you two different lengths of cable, one longer and one shorter, one depending on your needs. And what you're supposed to do is put this near your computer, and then you will have the capability to use your hands to interact with your computer. So the Leap Motion comes with their own app store with quite a comprehensive list of apps. So I've tried a few and I think that this is definitely going in the right direction. I've tried the chess game where I use my hand to pick up the chess pieces that I want and I move it on the chessboard on the screen. It takes a bit of getting used to because sometimes I position my hand too low or too high and it doesn't detect it very well. But generally, if you're doing simple gestures such as moving over and grabbing stuff, it detects quite well. So other than the chessboard game, I also try some telekinesis game where I pick up boxes and I throw it at floating robots. And there's also a lot of abstract apps where you just move your hands to interact with virtual water and virtual particles and so on. But when it comes to actual practical use for this thing, I feel that we are still not quite there yet because it brings fatigue to the hand very quickly and it's not as precise as a mouse where I can interact with the computer interface as accurately as I want to. So in my opinion, while this is really something cool that you can buy and play around with, it's not quite ready yet for prime time. You can't really use this for everyday use. The apps given on the App Store is also very basic and it's not very engaging, nothing remotely close to the video console games that you've been playing. But if you're interested in finding out what the future lies, I believe this is the key. With this, you can spend 5 minutes trying to be Tony Stark and after that, you will just be tired of it. If you're hoping to live like Tony Stark with this thing, no, this won't get you there. So yeah, but I think this device definitely gives you the glimpse of what the future lies. It is not quite ready yet. Likewise with all the current VR and AR gesture-based kind of products that you can buy in the market right now. But if you are someone who really likes to see what's available in the market, you can check this out. This is a really small product, doesn't take up a lot of space on your desk, and you don't need a very high power PC to run this thing. So yeah, if you're an average user trying to see what's available in the market, my recommendation is you don't have to get this. But if you're someone who's into the latest technology and you just want to see what's going to be available in the mainstream market in a few years time, do check out this product. So once again, this is the Leap Motion controller by Leap Motion. I'll leave the link in the description box below. So yeah, this is my quick review on the Leap Motion controller. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and like this video. I will see you next time. Bye bye.